Warning, the following content may contain elements that are not suitable for some audiences. Viewer discretion is advised.
Welcome back from sleeping, everybody. So we just got done sleeping. We are done resting. Let's make sure everything's on. And as you can see, it is still snowing. That is exactly how I like it. So we're gonna jump out of here. Go on and enjoy our ride as I'm about to turn the map off. Yeah, I know I didn't look. Turn off the map. Off. No, that's not what I wanted. Thank you. Wait, there you go. Okay. So, you know. So that's what's going on with American Truck Simulator. You know, they're saying, you know, they're saying February, you know, who knows? It could be more, it could be less, but I really do hope that is the, you know, end of, that it's the end of this month and beginning of next month. I'll really be happy for it, you know, and you know, so on from there. The only thing we don't know is we don't know what kind of cargo we'll be hauling, you know, or what they will start us off with. The one thing I wish that they would change, though, is maybe the skill set. You know, the skills on what you gain and all that. Because I really would, I think that'd be more interesting, maybe more history, you know, background of what you're gonna do, you know. I think that would really, you know, would really be better, you know, better, even a cutscene. I think that would, you know, would help out tremendously, you know, like, you know, for an example, like, let's just say you're going for your license to haul waste, which would be considered your hazmat license. You know, when you click on it, you know, have a little cutscene, you know, do maybe like a 15-second background on it, or whatever, you know, educate us a little bit more, educate the public that doesn't know, you know, what these truckers really do and what they go through, you know, and then just to add maybe a little more realism to it, you know, charge us, you know, charge us for the class, you know, maybe with points, maybe, you know, instead of getting a point that you can use for your skill, you know, maybe you can do it that, but like, you can maybe get a little bit better at it, you know, so, or make a little bit more money on it, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, go to the class and spend money. I'm not saying it has to cost, you know, $20,000 a class, but, you know, $150 a class, you know, something like that. Spend the money, you know, so you can do it. So it would give players like me more option. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, if I just want to stick to heavy hauling, I can. If I want to stick to just refrigerators and groceries, I can. But if I want to just stick to one, I can upgrade myself to a certain percentage, you know. That's just how I see it, you know. You know, the other thing that they have, that one of the questions was to them was that in one of the screenshots they saw a police car and a school bus. And one of the questions was that police car a just a decoration, or would that police car do, you know, do something? And the response to that was not right away. It won't do anything. But what they will do is add it into the game in later on, and it would be almost, it will be like speed cameras in Euro Truck Simulator. But instead of speed cameras, you know, they're gonna have these cop cars that will hide. That basically will be drivable AIs, you know, cops will drive around and either hide from you or whatever. And if you're breaking the law, they didn't go too much into depth on exactly what, you know, what would they pull you over for or try to pull you over for. But they say, you know, traffic enforcement. And if you're doing something wrong, they will chase you down, pull you over, you know. And they didn't say so much on, you know, if you can run from them, if that's an option, you know. So, but that would also add more realism to it. That would add more risk to it, you know. If you know you're hauling something, let's just say illegal, or you're over the weight limit for that stretch of road that you're on or that city, you know, that these cops nowadays, you don't necessarily have to go to a weigh scale. They have these portable weigh scales that they could pull out of their trunks, put it on the side of the road, and have you roll over them, and then weigh each scale. You know, so they didn't really go into that, or they didn't go into much about, you know, would you, you know, if you have any equipment violations, you know, headlights out, you know, tail lights, turn signals. They didn't really go into that much, but that's what they're saying, is that they're planning on putting an AI police car into it. Now, they also say about the buses, I think we're supposed to make a right here. Same thing with the buses. They said that you can drive the buses. Now, I don't know if that means that could be a totally different, separate career, or that could be a side job, or what it could be. But, you know, or it could be maybe, you know, you have an option. You know, they want you to take this bus from point A to point B, and they give you an option. Well, if you, you know, get it up on your, you know, if you get it up on your flatbread and you drive it, we'll pay you X amount of money. But if you drive it here, we'll pay you more than if you would put it on your truck. So then it'll give us an opportunity to drive, you know, more than just a truck. It would, you know, maybe they'll put in, you know, of course school buses, but maybe, you know, police cars, or, you know, or who knows, even dump trucks, front loaders, you know. You may never know. It could bring them in so many directions that it could possibly happen that way, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, why not? You know, why not? I would say, why not try it? You know? But like I said, that's just me. You know, we'll see how this, you know, how it goes and how they do with it. But that's what they said. They would eventually put in police cars and chase you down, possibly, you know. So that also gives me the impression that there will be citations or tickets, you know, but we don't know exactly to what. We don't know if it's going to be weight or, equipment violations or speed, or, you know, is just going to be speed. You know, so that, you know, that's the question, you know, and that's the question that, unfortunately, you know, they haven't either you know, either been asked and answered or they haven't even thought of it themselves. You know, making a game is as hard as it is. It really is. You know, you got these bugs and you got everything else and you got these glitches and, you know, and you want to make a good game for your fans, you know, especially SES that's been, you know, that's been doing this for, you know, for years. So they really don't want to disappoint their fans, but at the same time, they know that their fans want realism. They know that. And, but, you know, at the same time, can't add every realism thing in the game, because what's going to happen is you're demanding more from your developers and from your, you know, from your helpers to those debuggers, as I call them debuggers. So, you know, you're going to need that, and, you know, so you're going to need more people than you normally would do on a smaller version, on a smaller game. I would assume they probably would have doubled or tripled their staff when they're starting to talk about American Truck Simulator, because they would need it, you know, and then either cross train them so American Truck Simulator debuggers or helpers can help with the American game or with the Euro Truck Simulator game, or they're gonna have two different departments. So you're gonna need a lot more of them. As it is, so that means more money out of the cost of the company, because you have to pay them. And then you maybe will downsize a little bit once the game is released. But then there's things that's gonna happen. There's still gonna be bugs. There's still gonna be glitches. People are gonna be porting stuff. And in a way, you have to kind of feed out the kind of the new nuisance ones, like maybe, you know, I don't like the speed of the, you know, of the wipers compared to maybe, you know, well, when I get to this section of the road, I fall through the map and I can't get myself out, you know. So, you know, all that just, you know, takes time, you know, it really does. I also do wish that there will be more rain effect. I really do hope that they can maybe add, maybe more realism in the cabin. So, like, maybe when you turn on the radio, you know, instead of just hitting R in here, you know, on your controller or on the keypad, you know, you can just look to your radio, click on the knob with your mouse, and then the knob moves and turns on your radio, you know. Or, you know, whatever, you know, like your windows, you know, you can roll down your window, you know, and then you have that sound of your of the traffic and the wind blowing, you know, and pick up wind. That's just me, you know. I look at that stuff, you know, but like I said, you know, the more you put into it, the bigger staff you are going to need, because the bigger issues you're going to have. Not to mention, they want to have multiplayer in American Truck Simulator. They're not having that right off the bat. Eventually, oh crap! This is what I get for not paying attention. Come on, turn, so I can get there. You know, eventually, they will put in American Truck Simulator multiplayer. Eventually, but not at this very moment. So that's also, you know, that's also will be bugs and glitches and everything else. And then not to mention, you know, probably, you know, people reporting each other for reckless driving or, you know, for blocking the road, you know. So they're going to need people for that. They're going to need staff to monitor that 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And then people to monitor, you know, people that report that spam reports, you know. Of course you're going to have that. You're going to have this person. And I'm not saying it's just a kid. It could be an adult too, you know. Be just reporting people just because he wants to. You know, how would, you know. So then how is that would be fair to any of us to get banned or kicked when we didn't do anything? So that's going to be a whole different, you know, report. You know. So it is. Really? You wanna... Whatever. You know, so that's the other thing is, it's, you know, so that's more people. You know, that's more people that they have to, you know, more staffing and wanting more money. So, you know, and then you got to think about, you know, how much memory the game's going to need. You know, think about GTA. GTA takes, it needs two discs. The first one is to install it. And I can guarantee you that install disc doesn't install everything. It just installs key components onto your hardware so the game could work a little smoother instead of just solely relying on grabbing all the information from that disc. So same thing with, you know, same thing with PC games, you know, it's the space. And then think about this is, you know, not everyone's just gonna have one game. We, you know, a lot of us have, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 games, and some may you know, take up less space, some may take up more. It's really that. So, you know, if your game takes up 25 gigs of memory, you know, just think about how much power it's going to pull from the RAM and how much power it's going to pull from your card. So, you know, then they need to bump up the specs, and, you know, the higher your specs are, the less likely someone is going to, the less of people will be playing it, because they're not going to have that specs, and then they're going to look to see how much to upgrade their specs. Is it going to be, you know, some outrageous number, whatever it is, and then they're going to wait. So your launch success is not going to be as big as you hope, because these people got to wait. You know, and a lot of these gamers, you know, a lot of these PC gamers, you know, they're in it. You know, they really are. They are into these games. So a lot of them, you know, they want to run on maximum settings. They want to see every single detail and listen to the sounds and watch the grass grow, for instance. You know, that's just how it is. You know, when you're just starting off and you're kind of in the middle of, you know, being an amateur and a newbie, you kind of still don't really go with the graphics. You just want to play the game. But once you get to that expert on you know, playing these games and all that, then you start caring about graphics. You know, you want to see better trees and better roads, you know, the colors and all that. So those are the type of people that report these bugs and glitches, because, I mean, to me, unless it's obvious, like I'm just driving down this road now and I fall through the road and, you know, and I can't get myself back up or it won't cause me to recover, then that's a different story, then I'll report it. But if it's something minute, like, you know, how the sun glares off my mirror, I may not see it, or it may not be that much of an issue to me. Some people it may be. So, you know, it's just how it is. I do have to say, though, I do believe that American Truck Simulator, once it does get launched, and even if they do a pre-sale, I strongly believe it will surpass Euro Truck Simulator. Nothing against Euro Truck Simulator. I like it. I love it so far. It could use a little more improvements here and there, but that's any game. But I just strongly believe American Truck Simulator will, especially if it has a pre, you can buy it before the release date, will just surge past the launch numbers for when EST2 came out. But that's just me. A lot of us like it. You know, I really, just by judging, I really don't see a lot of people from the UK play your truck simulator too, I see more. I see more Americans play your truck simulator. I mean, I could be wrong. It could be just because they're just not recording it, and I don't know. You know, there might be just more Americans playing, you know, your truck simulator that are recording it than. Oh shit. Oh well. Fuck. Damn it. Now I'm getting myself on my way. God damn it. Well, at least we're doing a little bit of exploring, not as much as I really wanted to. Now I have to look for an exit or a place I can turn around. Help me without me going 20,000 miles out of my way. So that will be horrible. So you know, that's how I see it. I just look at the forums and look at the comments and what people are talking about online, and it's phenomenal, you know. Of course, we are a little, you know, older in age with technology and stuff, and a little newer than when EST2 came out, but still, it's phenomenal. You know, I really strongly believe that they will, you know, come out. Oh my God. I think it's time for me to look at a map and see how long this road goes before there's a goddamn forsaken fucking turnaround. It's not like I can go backwards. It's shit. It'll take me forever to go backwards. Alright, come on. Alright. Map. Wow. I'm not gonna have one until here. So if that's the case, then I'll just make a left. Yeah, I'll just make this big circle and then come over here. And then go down this way, because that's how it's going to be. No. I said no, thank you. I just want to make sure so I'm not going in circles. Yeah, okay. So, yeah, I so stupid. And I could have had that completed. I could have had all this. Fuck. Oh, well. So, you know, that's just me. You know, that's just what I believe and what I assume will happen is that. I can't believe I just probably added an extra hour to my time. God damn it. So, you know, that's just, you know, that's what my thoughts are. On it all. So, you know, I mean, like I said, who the hell knows? You know, it could be, you know, I could be wrong, but I highly doubt it, you know. I highly doubt that I am wrong, but, you know, we'll see. You know, we'll see if they even do a pre-release buy, you know, or if they would, you know, if they would do a, that was a little close. you know, or if they will do maybe something a little better, you know, like you have, okay, you have your standard, you know, ATS, or you can choose, you know, collection edition and you get something special. Who knows? You know, we won't know until, you know, until it comes out or until it's been announced, you know. But that's just me. Like I said, I can just see it on the forums and on YouTube that just to me, more people are excited about American Truck Simulator than the UK people. Don't get me wrong, there probably will be UK people driving and buying American Truck Simulator. But I foresee more people buying, more Americans buying American Truck Simulator than the UK. That's just me. Just like I would safely assume more UK people will bought, you know, Euro Truck Simulator too. You know, that's just, you know, my thoughts, you know, like I said, and YouTube, it doesn't mean it's, you know, it's true, you know, I was playing Euro Truck Simulator 2 before I even started recording, you know, I played it for a good year and a half before, you know, I decided, you know what, you know, I'm gonna do this and go make my, go start a channel on YouTube. Was I? Yes, I was. I was supposed to. Alright. Let's see what happens. I'm not, for some odd reason, I'm not paying attention and it's pissing me off. So. Alright. Diety. Let's see here. Got to make a right. Alright, here, let's do this. You know, so, but, you know, like I said, that's just me. That's just me, myself, and I, pretty much, you know. It's how it is, you know. Can I say? But yeah, you know, we'll see. You know, I would really, once ATS gets released, I would really like to see the numbers. Just out of curiosity, really. I would really love to see the numbers. That's just me though, you know? I would really like to see the numbers. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, I hope you guys are enjoying this winter mod. I am. Is that okay? It looked like a truck that was just stopped. So, you know, like I said, I'm gonna do this all the way until about end of February, beginning of March. But like I said, maybe even sooner. Depends on this, on the weather. You know, we finally had some chilly temperatures today. Been cloudy. I would say it's been hovering about 35, 40 degrees all day today. So it is a little chilly, you know, but come on. Accelerator, let it coast. And now I'm gonna have to, this is gonna be a really sharp turn. Was taken out. Good. could have been my loan. I do have a couple of them. What I have done is that was so weird how he's just like going so slow. That was weird. It like felt like I was on the wrong side of the road at first, you know? I forgot what I was talking about now. So, you know, but like I said, we'll see. Getting back to what I was talking about, I would love to see the numbers. I really would. Just, curiosity is killing me on the numbers and what they, and the difference between the two, you know? Popping into 11th over here, get a little more ground. Now we're going to pop it into 12. We got to kind of make up time, even though it's keeping us up at 55 miles an hour, 55, 56. Which I really don't understand why. Still can't figure that out. But yeah, anyway, so I really hope you guys enjoyed this mod. Like I said, you know, there you go. Now I remember. You know, it's finally been chilly. It's been around 35 to 40 degrees today all day, probably cloudy. We finally had some December winter for once. It's just so funny, 3 weeks before the end of December, and we're finally getting some winter weather, which technically winter doesn't start until the 21st. So, you know, what can you say? That is our sleep. I can guarantee it. Yes, it is. Alright. I'm going to see if I can make it to... My fuel is good. We're just a little bit above half, so we're good on that. But I'm going to see if I can get to the ferry. I really am hoping I can in time, so I don't have to rest and waste more time and hours. You know what I'm saying? So, break. All right, let's need brake gas, brake. All right, come on, turn. All right. Trying to get there, you know, as fast as I can. It doesn't exactly help that all these twists and turns in these roads. Oh my god, it's annoying. I do like how they have the sandbank, so I really do enjoy that. That's the other thing it would be nice to see if they can add in there is, you know, I'm gonna look at this map really quick. Why do we got so many of these? We don't need, Jesus Christ. Oh wow. It's like what would be better? Me making a left here, going down here and then making a right off of here. Go through here, go through, and then but I still have to go through this town, or just stick to the highway, do 55. Guess it doesn't really matter now, does it? So, you know, we'll, what they've been saying is we're supposed to have a very mild winter, and that is what we are having. So, but we will see. So today, I had to go. I had to go get new tires on the car. I really wanted to wait until after winter, but my wife noticed a bubble or bulge on the left front tire wall, and she was really concerned that it could not so much like explode, but it could leak air. Okay, whoa, neutral. So, it's funny how I didn't really stop that. I really wasn't going. Lord Jesus, trying to die? You gotta yield, you fucker. God damn it. Oh no, I'm not gonna stop. I'm just gonna pull out right in front of you. Hope you can stop. Lord Jesus. This is why I also talked about safety with you guys and for real life. Is if that happened in real life, I don't even know how fast I was going. I can tell you I was not going 37. I was probably going about 45. I can tell you now, that would have been a collision. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. This truck would have hit that bus. There is no questions about it. It would have happened. And that would have been horrible. So, you know, even now, come on, I know it's 37 miles a fucking hour, but Lord Jesus. The question is, can I overtake? Nope. Come on, get back. Alright, how about now? We'll see. 14. What I do like is at least they give you more room. At least they slow down. The other AIs, they will not. They will drive as fast as they were, and then the only way to get around them, especially now because you can only do, you know, with the speed limiter, it's harder because you can only do go up to a certain speed. So if they're maxing out at 56, and your max out is 55, it's no use. It's harder. So the only way to move in, or if you have another, car going in the other direction, the only way is to, I just saw that train. I'm going for it, maybe. I really do like that sound though. You heard me going over the railroad tracks. That is actually, I love that sound. But I really have bad time with those railroad tracks. I remember quite a while ago, I was going over railroad tracks. I was doing a little faster than this, actually. I was doing, I think, 60, 65. And I got halfway through, just halfway through the tracks, and just instant stop, 25% damage to the trailer, and I think it was like 56% damage to the tractor. I mean, 56 to the trailer, 25% to the tractor. And, I really did not like it. Oh God, avoiding sleep, of course. We just can't catch a break today. But it was my fucking mistake. It's a little steep of a hill right here. We're gonna kind of slow it down. Not a hill, but a turn, and we don't want to tip. Even though I want to get there as fast as I can, so I can have less penalties, but. Same time, I don't want to flip it because then it's just not going to do me any good either. So, but anyways, that's why I did that safety video for anybody that wanted to know or learn. Because I can tell you now, if that was in real life, it would not have happened. because that there is no way that bus would have been able to pick up that much speed in that much quick of a time. I can tell you now. Because he would have had to drop down to about, I would say about 50 miles, and no, no, like 15. And to make that turn correctly without either going to the other lanes or without tipping over. So it would have definitely been that. And that would have been horrible. So he would have had to drop down to about 15 to 10, make that turn, and then to catch up to speed, he would just not have made it. I gotta say, behind this suicide jockey, I'm gonna start using those terms that I mentioned, CB lingo earlier. I'm gonna stay behind the suicide jockey, even though I really don't want to, because it's my life if he crashes, or if I crash into him. I could possibly, I would assume, I'm just looking at his hazmat triangle, and I would safely assume that triangle means that it is hazardous, and or that also it could be explosives, which means it could explode. Come on. Yes, I know I'm getting tired. Thank you for letting me know. Let's see. 14. Accelerate. Right turn signal. So, I'm gonna start using those lingos, but I really want to get past this guy. Because he's just gonna be slow all day. Whoa! Did not see that car there. It looked like more like a bush. Really did. I swear to God, it did. So, anyways, getting back. So, the only way to have the AI pull over is I'm actually gonna jump behind this moving parking lot if I can slow down in time. Is by putting on your four ways, and to the AI, you trick the AI into thinking that you're stopped in the middle of the street, which would cause them to slow down. So that's one way to get around them. But I don't know why I still have my turn signal on. So that is also a tricky. But yeah, so I needed to get new tires. I got them done. Got them done at Goodyear. Just a little past a half mile from where I'm at. And I walked all the way home and walked there. And, got them back. So got the car back about an hour ago. They look good. I think any car with good tread always looks good. Even though I know I'm not supposed to be overtaking on a curb, so don't mind this. Really don't mind this. Really just don't mind this. Close your eyes. That's what I tell my wife. Just close your eyes. That's the one thing I kind of do like, that the AI do slow down and kind of stop. Because before, they would have kept on going. They would not have stopped. They would not have stopped. So, I really don't want to rest. I really don't. I really just do not want to rest. I just want to get there. As much as money and all that I'm losing, I really just don't want to. Oh, shit. Stop. Jesus. And that waste time. Oh God, Jesus Christ, that was too close. Oh my God. If you were here right now, you'll see that my heart is pounding. Like, not like crazy, like Jumanji style, but it's a pumping. It is a pumping. So yeah, so I got new tires. I really do like them. Nothing too crazy. They are, apparently they either make integrity tires. They're the company's made by Goodyear. They're called Goodyear Integrity Tires. And I guess they either make them for smaller vehicles. So I used to have them on my 97 Ford Taurus. So I guess they don't make them for my Ford Fusion. So I went with All Insurance, Goodyear. They're a little more expensive. $125 a tire. $65,000. Oh my God, 65,000 mile tread life on them. They do come with a free tire rotation every 6 months or every 3,000 miles, which I do. You really don't have to do it. It all depends on how much you drive and all that. But you really don't have to do it. And as much as I really wanted to get past this truck, I guess it's just not going to happen. I think this is the turn I got to get off anyway. So it comes with that. And the wheel alignment, I got to look into that. It says wheel alignment every once a year, or I think it's like 12,000 miles. I don't know if that's included in the warranty or included in it, and they do it for free like they do the balance. Not balance, but tire rotation. Oh my God, come on! Definitely, you know, but I gotta see, because they do recommend that. So, with that being said, this I'm actually gonna swing out a little bit more, because if not, I'm not gonna make, that turn, and then what happens is my trailer gets hooked up on it, and then it lifts my drive wheels off the ground, and then I'm just sitting there spinning my tires, and it'll take me an extra 20 minutes just to get off. So, oh my God, that was worst decision ever. Well, I didn't have much of a choice. I was already committed. It's not like I had a choice in the matter. I might even be skipping gears. Who the fuck knows? Let's do that. Let's skip gears today. Skipping gears. Alright, now we should take this all the way to... all the way to the... Fuck my life! To the deer... Ah, shit! Course. That is not what I wanted. Really did not. At least I only got 2% and 4% on my cargo. Really did not want that to happen. Yes, I know I'm getting tired. Shut up. 7. I gotta go into here. 8. 9. This is really turning out to be the worst. Every time I do an external contract, it's worse. Like, this cannot get any worse. And it is. Come on, come on. Come on, four-wheeler. Genius! Go. That's what you get for turning your signal on all the way up there. Oh my God, now I'm dozing. Turn the fucking wheel, dude. Really? Like, I'm really starting to get pissed off here. Like, you have no fucking idea. This is really starting to fucking piss me off. 11. Let's go. 12. 13. Before I go sliding into something else. Well, not really sliding. Six percent. Of course. So I saw that coming. Oh my God, horrible. Come on, turn. Thank you. Right turn. Alright, come on, turn right. There you go. Alright, slow and down. 7 and 13, alright, let's go. Come on, turn, 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 turn! Yes, come on. Thank you. I could have done two more loads. Thank you, service. So I'm not gonna just I said off with the wipers. That is what I said. I want to get to the ferry. That's all I want to do. I'm waiting for it. Yep, I knew it was coming. See, I can't get to 15 because there's no point. Turn now. Don't fucking flip over, you piece of shit. Alright, come on. Off with the turn signal, thank you. We can do this now. Jesus Christ. Just wasting more time. Alright, come on, turn. Thank you. Alright. Get up to speed. Get up to speed. Yes, avoiding sleep. Blah, 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 blah. Shove it up your ass. At this point, I really just don't give a shit. Come on. I know it's about to do it. Yep, there it goes. Do I go straight? What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? I go straight. No, I don't. I turn. Yes, I'm going to sleep. Congratulations. Off with the turn signal, because it's really fucking driving me fucking insane. Turn! Thank you! Much obliged. Finally, fucking here. Come on. Alright, let's stop. Yep, I knew that was coming. Once again, I have to swing out so I can make it. Yeah. No, that is not what I wanted. Alright, guys. This is where I'm going to end it, and I'm going to pick it up when I get across the sea. Until then, I will talk to you later. Bye.